Water is the lifeblood of civilization. What happens when that life-giving resource vanishes? Deadly drought has gripped the American West in a stranglehold.
Drought coverage now with a new emergency proclamation issued.
There is heightened concern about the American West power supply.
A mega drought in the West becoming a massive problem.
Exceptional and extreme drought conditions, those are the two worst categories.
And now the news is about to get even worse.
Cattle ranchers across the U.S. are selling off herds because they cannot afford to feed them.
The conditions are helping fuel several wildfires early in the season.
The drought that has hit the Western United States for years is getting worse.
The drought in California is already impacting the food that you put on your table.
Now the situation has become so dire that agricultural users are being cut off completely.
100% of the state of California suffering a worsening drought.
An already bad drought could get even worse.
Lake Oroville hit a record low level.
Record-breaking heat and a lack of rainfall.
We begin tonight with the oppressive heat wave.
Rising temperatures and lightning.
Now to the bone-dry conditions.
Blackouts
threatening to paralyze the country.
This is by far the worst.
Extreme drought.
Dozens of large fires. This heat comes a drought emergency.
You know, it could get dangerous around here just because there's not going to be enough water for people.
Empty reservoirs and lake beds have become a direct threat to our very existence. Nearly 75 million people across the American West are facing catastrophe. Effects of the mega drought are far-reaching and will persist for years, but drought is only a symptom of a diverse climate problem. It will get worse. Lake Oroville in Northern California normally provides 25 million people with water, irrigates 750,000 acres of farmland, and generates power for 80,000 homes. But not anymore. Water levels have dropped so significantly, hydroelectric plants have been forced to shut down.
Those are having profound effects on the power, the hydroelectric power supply, as well as water that comes off of those reservoirs for big cities like Phoenix and Los Angeles.
Now to our drought emergency. For the first time ever, water levels at Lake Oroville have gotten so low its power plant had to be shut down.
California's drought and the state's energy struggles come together in one single place.
We know it's going to be severe.
The water from Lake Mead along the Nevada-Arizona border serves 2 million people in New Mexico, 3 million people in Nevada, 7 million people in Arizona, and a whopping 39 million people in California. Lake Mead is now at its lowest level since it was filled in the 1930s. The intense heat conditions have killed hundreds of people. Little to no rainfall and poor snowpack has triggered tinderbox conditions, sparking countless raging wildfires.
We've seen that especially in the Northwest and in the Southwest, where they've had day after day of unprecedented heat, and people have died of heat-related, you know, illnesses and health problems.
And this is only the beginning.
The problem is that you go into summer with water shortages because the snow isn't lasting as long on the mountain.
Snowpack in the Rockies, Cascades, and Sierra Nevada mountains feed streams, rivers, lakes, and reservoirs. These in turn give humanity water to drink and provide irrigation for crops and livestock. A third of the country's vegetables and two-thirds of fruits and nuts are grown in California. A critical supply of meats and grain come from now drought-stricken western states. Now, crops are dying and herds of livestock are being culled and sold across the country. What follows next should be of grave concern for everyone in America, because once that water is gone, chaos will ensue, resulting in the largest migration away from the West Coast in U.S. history. As humans are forced to seek the most basic and important commodity in the world, fresh water.